27. As you can see, I've been working around, so this will actually be the last, we'll complete the set. So find double angle. So we're going to need to use a double angle formulas. We're given what the sine of x is, and we're told that it's in the second quadrant. So what this, knowing the sine of x, the value of the sine of x, we'll actually be able to construct a triangle. So we'll start off with that. So we're in the second quadrant. We know we're over here. So triangles over in the second quadrant always look like the right triangles. We want the angle here to come off the central angle. Now, what we would actually use if we were going to measure its theta is we use it from zero, so it's an obtuse angle. But to set up the triangle, this is what we want to think of this angle. We're given that sine of x is 1 over square root of 5. And so remember, x is the angle, and really x is this angle from here to here. So it's more than 90 degrees. Now, we don't know exactly what it is. So I just want you to think of that. When we take 2 times that angle, it's very much likely to be either in the third or the fourth quadrant. So we're not going to be in the second quadrant anymore when we multiply by 2. But let's set up this triangle. So sine is opposite over the hypotenuse. So what this tells us is the opposite side, so here's our, thinking of this as our angle, the opposite side is 1. The hypotenuse is the square root of 5. And this is when, I've seen some of you had some troubles with this. We are going to subtract. So we square both and then subtract to get this side here, to get the adjacent side, the ADJ. Okay, so we're going to take the square root of square root of 5 squared minus 1 squared. So we're taking the hypotenuse minus one of the legs squared, using the Pythagorean theorem. Square root of 5 squared is 5. 1 squared is 1. And look, it makes it really nice. 5 minus 1 is 4. Square root of 4, well, that's just 2. So the adjacent side is 2. So we've got 2. We've got our opposite side. We've got the hypotenuse. Okay, so with all of that together, we can now find the sine of 2x, cosine of 2x, tangent of 2x. What we're going to need to pull up is our formula sheet. And again, during the exam, you'll be able to pull this up either electronically, or you can bring it in to the exam with you, print it out. Just remember, the unit circle needs to be blank. That's the thing you fill out at the beginning. And if you're using it electronically, you might want to fill out the unit circle on your scratch paper and just kind of sketch it out. But I'll leave all that up to you. So we've got these double angle identities. So sine is one of the easiest ones. There's only one. With cosine, we've got 3 choices, and sometimes, you know, you wish you only had one. All of them will work, so they'll give us the same value. Anyway, let's go with sine of 2a for 2x. So we're going to find the sine, the first one, sine of 2x. And the way we break it down, that's going to be 2 times the sine of alpha times x. So that's 2 sine of x times the cosine of x. Now, sine of x was already given to us, so that's kind of cool. So this is going to be 2, 1 over square root of 5. So we know that's just good. Cosine of x, remember, is going to be the adjacent over the hypotenuse. So the cosine of x is going to be 2 over square root of 5. And again, this is going to be the answer for sine of 2x. I like to do this. So this 2, think of it as 2 over 1. So we get 2 times 1 is 2, times 2 is 4. So 4 in the numerator. In the bottom, square root of, well, I guess 1 times square root of 5 is square root of 5. Square root of 5 times square root of 5 is 5, right? A square root times a square root does that. So 4/5, that is what sine of 2x is. Now, sorry here, I forgot. We're in the second quadrant. One of these is negative. It's not the y, it's the x. Okay, so before I get too overconfident, since the 2 is negative, I've got a negative here, so when I multiply, my end result is going to be here. And that indeed shows us this is now in maybe the third or maybe the fourth quadrant. We don't know what this angle is yet. Depends on whether it's maybe close to 90 degrees or closer to here, but it could be either in the second or third. So right now we know when sine is negative that this has to this two sine of 2x is negative. We know we're either in the third or the fourth. We'll get our answer when we get to cosine. Anyway, let's come back here. Let's put in this answer while we're at it. Minus 4 over 5. Okay, we'll keep going. And you can be certain so far in doing all of this, I did make one sort of error. I redid one video. And it was, I actually had the right answer, but because it wasn't in the domain, I needed the negative angle. So that was one. But all of these, I'm checking the answers on by submitting it. And so these answers are going to be correct. Okay. I don't check them until after, but if they didn't work, I delete the video and start over. Okay. So let's cosine of 2x. Okay. And again, for this one, we've got multiple choices of which formula we want to use. They will all give us the same value. That's the idea behind an identity. We could use any one that we want. So we're double angle formulas. Which one shall we use? My gut feeling tells me since I've got this choice, let me go with the one that just has sine because sine is given to us. If in the off chance I made some kind of an error in my triangle, I'm going to make this one will like almost be guaranteed to be correct because it's not going to involve any calculations on my part. Does that make sense? So cosine of 2x, if I do it in terms of 1 minus 2 times sine squared of x. I'm going to come back and they gave us, right? Let's see, where are we? They gave us that sine of x equals 1 over squared. I'm just going to use that. If I made some kind of an error over here, I'm still going to get this one correct. If I used one of the terms that had both cosine and sine or just cosine and I was wrong here, I'm going to have a wrong answer. So it's just kind of, when I take tests, I look for, okay, which one's going to be the involve the least amount of calculations on my part just so I can do it. Okay, so sine x is 1 over square root of 5. So what we're going to do is we're going to replace sine x with 1 over square root of 5, but it's sine squared, so we're going to square it. Okay, so that we do like that, and then we multiply it by 2, and we take 1 minus it. That's going to be cosine of 2x. Okay, so now we'll do the math. What is 1 over square root of 5 squared? Well, it's 1 over 5. So when I square it, I get 1 over 5. I take the 2 times the 1, so that's 1 minus 2/5. And think of 1 as 5 over 5, right? We'll get common denominator. 1 is the same thing. So 5 minus 2, we end up with 3. 3/5. And it's positive, right? Because I just copy that formula. You see, the sign we were given, we're told it's in the second quadrant, so we know it's positive, and we end up with a positive value. Where is cosine positive? Well, it's not in the third, it's in the fourth quadrant. So that tells us our angle was large enough that 2 times the angle gets us into the fourth quadrant. Anyway, this is pretty guaranteed. Now, that's kind of one way you could also, when we're doing these, you could come back and see if you got the same thing for cosine of 2a, 2 cosine squared a minus 1. We could go ahead and do that. That's not a, it's an alpha. But and if you got the same answer, which you're supposed to, then it's kind of a way to make sure that you did this part right. If we don't get the same answer, then we know, oh, we messed up on the cosine. So let's bear with me. If you want to fast forward, you can do this, but I just want to show you these strategies that help with taking tests to make sure you're getting the right answer. So I'm going to also do the cosine of 2x. I'm going to rework it in a second way as 2 cosine squared. And then the minus 1's here. So cosine we came up with is, what is it? It's adjacent over hypotenuse, so it's negative 2 over 5. So that gives us 2. Negative 2 over square root of 5, sorry. And we're going to square that, and then we're going to subtract 1. So negative 2 squared is going to give us 4, positive 4. Square root of 5 squared is 5. So we get this. 2 times that minus 1. 2 times 4 is 6. Do that right? I'm not feeling confident about this now. 2 times 2, that's 4 over 5. Oh, no. 2 times 4, I was adding. See, this is the algebra. 2 times 4 is 8. It's not 6. And I was thinking ahead, and 6 wasn't going to work well for us, but 8 will work perfectly. 2 times 4 is 8. You see how easy it is to get your facts off. And then we're subtracting 1, so we're subtracting 5 over 5. 8 minus 5 is 3/5. We matched. We got 3/5 working with this one. We also got 3/5 working with the other one. It's a way of building confidence that we set our triangle up correctly, because we need to get the same answer. Okay. If we didn't, then we would know to come back. We had a problem here, because again, we use the one that was given to us to get the 3/5. We can be pretty confident with that. Okay. Just some strategies to think your way through there and do well. Let's see. Let's come down here and let's do tangent of 2x. So I want to go to that one. Let's get this one. Tangent of 2x, that's the one that's 2 tangent of alpha over 1 minus tangent squared alpha. Okay, so, or, you know, since it's the same angle, since we have the sine and the cosine, you could take the value for the sine of 2x, which is negative 4/5, divided by 3/5. So let's do that, and then I'm going to double check. I will use the formula just to make sure, but it's sine of 2x over cosine of 2x is another way to think of tangent of 2x. It might be easier to do it this way. So sine of 2x we came up with was negative 4/5. Cosine of 2x we came up with 3/5. Remember, when you have a fraction divided by a fraction, you take the bottom one, flip it, and multiply. 5 over 3. The 5's are going to cancel. Our answer should be negative 4/3. And that would make sense to be in the fourth quadrant, right? Because fourth quadrant is x is positive, y is negative. But let's go ahead and use this formula just to stretch it out a little bit. So tangent of 2x should be 2 times the tangent of alpha. And what's the tangent of alpha? So we go back to our triangle, and that is going to be tangent is opposite over adjacent, 1 over negative 2. That's 2. That's 1 over negative 2. Okay. Divided by 1 minus tangent squared. So since tangent is 1 over negative 2, it's going to be 1 over negative 2 squared. Let's give some more room here. So in the numerator, we get 2 times 2. It's not looking real promising, but maybe, you know, just keep going. 2 times 2 is 2. 2 over 2, right? So the numerator's 2 over negative 2. That's just going to be negative 1. In the denominator, when we square negative 1 half, we're going to get 1 over 4. Right? 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4. And then, so since we're subtracting from 1, we want to write 1 as 4 over 4. 4 over 4 is 1. It's just a different, so we have our common denominator. Oh, that's going to work. So this gives us negative 1 in the numerator. In the denominator, we're going to get 4 minus 1, which is 3 fourths, positive 3 fourths. And then remember, we've fraction divided by a fraction, or this is now 1. So it's negative 1 divided by 3 fourths. So you flip and multiply, that's 4 thirds, positive 4 thirds. But then this negative, we end up with negative 4 thirds, which we got over here as a check. So again, we feel fairly confident because we've done it two different ways and we got the same values. Again, maybe you don't want to do that because of timing issues, but I just want to show you multiple ways. And that is 27, and that will complete our review. We've gone through all the problems, so keep on studying. If you do well on this, once you do well on this, you can do this multiple times. You will be well prepared for the exam.